very best in American tradition. No, this land is not the land of Jimmy Carter. It is not the land of Andy Young. It is not the land of Marvin Harrington. It's not the land of the city council. It is your land. It is my land. It is our land. This is our land. So by being here today, you're making it plain and crystal clear that this is our land, and we will struggle, we will fight, we will do whatever it takes to keep this land and pass it on to the next generation. We must be prepared to use the tactics, yes, the techniques, a non-violent, direct action to stop this road. If necessary, you must be prepared, all of us, to withdraw our support from those people who support this road. For this road is evil.
Yes, I do. We got a lot more people here today. We got more people being arrested. We got more people joining every day. So we're not going to stop till the road's ended. So
this is getting pretty dangerous. So I've seen one small child right next to the crane.
And well, we don't want just, the cranes just, in the park.
Just now we just saw a child.
The park is for the kids. You know, this is where our kids are going to play.
It's public land.
It's a public land. They don't have these to it.
Illegal vote!
I'm concerned about people getting hurt. I'm also concerned about all the trees they cut down. I'm concerned about where the kids can play safely. They can't play on a superhighway.
Tent City, erected in self-defense of Shadyside Park by the Roadbusters. Shadyside was designed in 1893 by famed landscape architect Frederick Law Olmsted, who also designed Central Park in New York City and Yosemite in California. It was this land that City Council President Marvin Arrington illegally transferred to the state DOT, paving the way for the Presidential Parkway and also for a near $1 million contract for his own subcontracting company. Incidentally, Arrington was also the attorney for Shepherd Construction in their 1982 bid rigging case. Five people were arrested here on February 4th, climbing the trees they hoped to save. The commuters who will be the benefactors of this highway are picketed with good spirits, and they respond with overwhelming support for the protesters.
Never has such a short road damaged so many historic districts with such little justification and with so much corruption.
We think it's unanimous that people do not want a roadway, parkway, expressway, or anything through their park.
Civil disobedience and what that really means. And I can't stand here and tell you to go out and get arrested. But I think there are enough people out here who are as committed as we are, or more committed, and who really would get involved in this way. And I can only urge anyone who feels they have the time and the commitment to do this to do it. Our charges were dismissed on Friday in court, the four of us. Because we were right, and we were acting out of necessity. And how hard it would have been if it was on the trial that the act of necessity for forming a crime, a smaller crime to prevent a greater crime from being committed. And that greater crime is these corrupt, money and power hungry people coming tramping through our neighborhood without ever talking to us about it. We're mad. We're really mad. And we've got to commit ourselves.
How do you guys feel about the parkway?
Stinks.
It stinks. I hate it.
They shouldn't do that.
They just shouldn't do it.
Why?
Because kids will come out and they go on the street and get run over.
Yeah, I mean, old people will be able to cross the street.
We ride our bikes around there sometimes and we won't be able to.
I don't see why they just don't leave it alone. I mean, it's fine the way it is.
How about the sledding?
The sledding.
Great.
In the wintertime when it's snows like this, we won't even be able to go sled riding if they put this dumb street here.
So you're going to be out there supporting or protesting against it then, huh?
Yes.
I'm not going to do anything like sleep in tents, but
But I will in the daytime.
I don't like it.
I will protest.
They're all here, and there's plenty of blame and plenty of shame to go around. Plenty of shame to fill two or three presidential libraries.
So now Jimmy Carter is one of the most unwelcome men in the neighborhood of the Jimmy Carter Presidential Library. Ben Jones, longtime neighbor and star of TV's Dukes of Hazzard, once campaigned for Carter.
And then go down there and fatten themselves on the public trough. Let's get rid of them all. Shame old Jimmy Carter, your friend and mine. I hope you read Paul Hemphill's column the other day.
Yeah!
He said it for a lot of us. Shame on, it's real trendy to attack Jimmy, but he deserves it, folks. That's why it's a trend. You know, when a guy like that doesn't care about the feelings of the people who cared so much about him, he deserves what he gets. Jimmy Carter. I campaigned for him in 1980 in the last days of his last campaign in West Virginia. Barnstorming with then-Governor Jay Rockefeller, and we won West Virginia. And I spoke for Jimmy Carter, and I spoke from my heart. And I said, he's not a hawk, he's not a dove, he's an American eagle. And they cheered, but I've revised my opinion. You got it. He's a bird, all right. Maybe an ostrich for sticking his head in the sand and refusing to look at this. Or maybe he's just a buzzard sitting up in a tree and watching neighborhoods die. Yeah. No, he said he's just a plain old ordinary South Georgia turkey. Yeah. Jimmy, and this part, okay, you know, I'm all for it. I think most of us are. Seriously, folks. The great park, remember when we dreamed about that and what it could be and what it could do for our neighborhoods and our cities? And what a little parkway like Piedmont Park had, all that great thing that would have brought people back into the middle of this city. But I think it was Amy's idea. Amy said, Daddy, why don't you have a library? Franklin Pierce has a library. Millard Fillmore has a library. That's good. I'll have a library. Let me call Carl. Let me call Andy. Somebody better call Marvin. So now we have it. Jimmy Carter giving his tour of the presidential library. Over here, we're going to have a seminar room. Our first seminar is on how to perpetuate double-digit inflation. Over here is the children's section. We have books like Tales of a Killer Rabbit and Adventures of Wild Brother Billy. Over there will be the Hubert Horatio Horndoyle card catalog. And y'all look out here. That's my parkway. No, it's not Road Atlanta. That's my parkway. Every afternoon.
blows at 5 o'clock. It takes people from downtown Atlanta out to the suburbs. And it takes the tax money with them. But one day, that parkway, my little parkway, will run all the way from downtown Atlanta to Gwinnett County, where it will connect up with Jimmy Carter Boulevard. Because they'll never be on Mount Rushmore. They don't have room for two more faces.
This is Hollywood Land.
We have the right to be here.
Do not arrest us falsely. This is Hollywood Land. We have a right to be here.
Put it on yourself.
Do not arrest us falsely.
The statement, you shouldn't look a gift horse in the face. I'd like to turn that around and say there's some gifts you can't afford to accept. And if one of them is a library that requires them to stab your heart, you ought not to accept that gift. Or if they want to give you a building here or there and call it a contribution to the public welfare, but it entails damaging parks and historic districts and neighborhoods, you can't afford to accept that gift. There is no future for the city that destroys its own people in order to help a person who isn't even a resident of this city to satisfy his ego needs.
celebrations until then, but we are going to plan one or two as a temporary celebration.
I'm absolutely delighted. It's the break we've been needing. From now on, I think we're going to find better and better ways to stop the road. We're going to stop it. I'm convinced.
Well, I think it's pretty great. I just wish it were for a lot longer, and because I really feel that our parks have been stolen from us.
A decision is finally reached in the courts. He said the fate of the roadway, however, will have no bearing on his library and mediation center.
I have zero federal funding dollars.
So you won't stand to lose any money if we don't get the parkway?
I don't have anything but private contributions with which the library and the Carter Center are built. And when the library is finished, it'll be operated in perpetuity by the federal government, regardless of access roads. The Carter Center, which will be adjacent to the library but separate, will be owned and operated by Emory University.
So the plans for the library will continue without regard to the fate of the highway.
Travesty of justice. This is disgusting. It's the most outrageous decision. It has such an incredibly negative impact on our city that the road is illegal. We can prove it now. We have so much. We proved it many years ago. It's illegal. So we're going to stop it.
But it is absolute folly, it seems to me, politically and economically and any other way, to destroy or damage neighborhoods and parks if it is not necessary for a higher good. And it is very clear now that you do not have to have this road in order to have this presidential library and the policy center and that development. The DOT acknowledges this quite forthrightly now. And it just seems to me that that's a form of a kind of political and economic suicide, to slap people in the face who are supporting your city and trying to rebuild the close-in neighborhoods. And that's unnecessary, so why do it? And that's hard for us to understand.
I think that you got a group of true believers that are waging what they feel to be a kind of a crusade. And we've been very tolerant, and nobody's decided to take them on. And I think we're paying a price for it.
In my judgment, it's basically a cynical attempt to try to influence the Georgia Supreme Court through the media.
Says cautions Richard Ossoff, the parkway will not be built. Says the mayor, it will be built.
Right. This project, as you know, and as I think the commissioner himself would admit, seems to have a life of its own. And I think someone was quoting Casey Stengel recently. He said, it's not over, Yogi Berra, perhaps. It's not over till it's over. And I think that probably is an apt statement. It's dying. The presidential parkway will not be built, but whether this saga is over or not, I think it's premature to say.
And indeed, of course, today's action did not necessarily sound the death knell for the parkway. Moreland says the contract allows for the cancellation of the contract in the event of a court injunction, which is what happened, and he exercised that right. But he says he still hopes to build the road. He says if the legislature grants the power for the state to condemn the city property, he says he'll do it and take new bids for the construction.